All right. Okay, so bachcha log, we start. And even if it's a formality, I like to welcome you all here, okay, for this lecture of mine. Today we talk about some very familiar topic to you, which you have known very well at the undergraduate level. However, we will make some formal derivation. Okay? And even the statement, I am talking about the so-called uncertainty principle or uncertainty relation. So based on the theory of operators, we will derive it. Before we proceed to derive it, let me make the statement which you may not really be knowing, because most of the people don't know it in that way. Okay. So if we consider any two Hermitian operators A and B, and if we assume that A and B commute with each other, it would mean commutation relation of A, B is 0, which means A, B minus B, A is 0. If that happens, then A and B can be measured accurately simultaneously. Okay? Did you know this part?
Yes.
Oh, that's good. That makes me happy. The next part is, if they do not commute, and if we still want to make a simultaneous measurement of these two things, eventually an operator represents some physical observable. Okay, we associate operators to the physical observables. Alright? So, if they do not commute, then there would be some error or uncertainty involved in the measurement of one of the two. You can measure one of them accurately, but then if you measure the other, there will be an inaccuracy or uncertainty or error involved in the measurement of the other. So it depends on you whether you want to measure A or you want to measure B accurately. Then the uncertainty would be the measurement of the other. That is how the statement of the uncertainty principle goes. And let us now make some simple derivations. I would give you two different ways to derive it, okay, and that's what I propose to do today. And by the way, somehow my date of departure for, I propose to go to Germany, and it has to be preponed by one more week. So this means that 18th or 17th is Saturday. That might be the last date when I lecture to you people, and then my other colleagues would take over. I wanted to do it more, but the offer of giving a talk there is also very tempting. So I enjoy giving talks, you might have noticed it. So whether it is my students or some people somewhere else, okay. So that means I will be lecturing to you after this week for 3 more weeks, maybe in your class. So to the other class, 4 weeks, I mean this week and 3 more weeks. So, alright, I am still at the so-called first paragraph of your syllabus, where I am trying to cover up things which have been left here and there. Okay. Alright, so this I should be able to do by tomorrow. today I propose to make up this derivation of transcendental principle and all the things related to this. And tomorrow, I would like to take the space displacement operator. Okay? And then from Monday, I take the time to work. So gradually we will move towards the quantum dynamics. Okay? Very good. So now once the statement is clear, we can proceed to... So let me see that computation relation of A and B, let me assume that this is given by iota time C. Okay? You can very easily see, in the first place we say that V dagger equals to A, V dagger equals to B, V dagger equals to C. Now what happens to the situation? A, B, take the dagger of this equation. Okay? Now this is a joint of this equation and A, B. So this is your A, B minus B, A and this condition is joint. So this would be equal to the B dagger, A dagger minus A dagger, B dagger, and this would be equal to BA minus A B, and this would be equal to BA, and this would be equal to minus AB. So what you find is that this commutator of A and B is anti-Hermitian. A and B are Hermitian operators. However, the commutator of A and B is AB. So then this then what about I into C? So I into C dagger should be C dagger and I dagger, this is what? Minus I C. Okay? So this is also an increase. Okay? So left hand side and right hand side both. Left hand side is anti-Hermitian and right hand side also. So everything is consistent, everything is fine. A, B, C are individually Hermitian and the left hand and right hand side of the equation are anti-Hermitian, each one of them is anti-Hermitian. So this is fine. Everything is fine. Very good. Now, let me define delta A, this is A minus expectation value of A, and delta B is B minus value of B, and its expectation values, A, expectation values A and B and all of us that will come in the future are taken with respect to an arbitrary state. So your A is psi B I and V psi. And of course we assume that so you consider an arbitrary state psi which is normalized to unity so that its log is 1 and V W expectation then A and V is state. Okay, so whatever expectation value we would be considering, all of them would be taken with respect to the same state psi. This is because we are interested in the simultaneous measurement of the state field. So we always keep the arbitrary state the same. Alright? Okay. And what are these things? These are root mean square. Root mean square, that is of A and B. These are the root mean square variations of A and B. If you know a little bit of statistics, okay, then you would know this. Okay? Very good. Now, one can proceed further. So, could I remove this? That might be better. Okay. I leave most of this area. This is what I have assumed. So this I am defining as this. The only point I wanted to say that sometimes you might think by repeating this hierarchy. It is because we want to ensure that both these sides are empty. Otherwise, left hand side in any case would be empty. Okay. So right hand side you cannot assume it to be equal to just C, an operator C. Because C by itself is Hermitian. But this right hand side also has to be empty. So that's the point. So you assume it equal to alpha times C. Now you can define delta A, we have defined there, and it's the square, and it's the expectation value, all of them with respect to the same state psi. So A minus B whole square and psi, okay, and this you can expand, so this is psi e square plus e square minus 2e, and this psi, so this is your equivalent. Psi A square minus of if I already take the expectation value of then I will say A square plus A square minus where, so this is equal to minus A square. Okay. Similarly, I can write delta B root square equal to now, let me construct. I wish to define or construct a new operator P. I want to define as P is equal to delta K plus I D times the P. Okay? So you can put this value and you can find that this will be P minus this K plus I D times B minus this place over. Alright? So this is part and fine. Okay, if you like like this. Now I also want to define the new display phi, and I define it as new screen is no dot. You disturb all other people here getting you, right? So I construct the new screen part, which is defined as C operating on this screen. Right? So and then I would like to calculate the norm of the system by phi, this would be psi, then p psi, right? And obviously, we are working in a geometric space, in a complex linear vector space, characterized by the positive definite law, which is what we understand as the geometric space. So, if this is the norm, has to be equal to 0. Alright? So we simply calculate the left hand side of this inequality and we find out what it is. Okay? So phi, this is your psi three dagger. P phi, this is equal to that. And okay, so this we have to put is dagger. So its dagger would be that okay, let me write, let me use this. Delta A, if delta would be minus pi D, delta B, times P itself, which is delta A plus pi D, delta B. Alright? Please, my dear friend, if you give a parallel lecture, below, with the action of 1%, all the rest of the classes is done. This is a very simple thing. If you dare to understand this, then I have nothing to say. Okay? Such a simple thing. Okay? Each one of us has to contribute towards maintaining a system. You cannot expect Mr. Modi to come here and discipline us, each one of us, to take care of each one of us. Okay? It's a lesson in our country to keep blaming for others except ourselves. Okay? If we take care of the things ourselves, we do not contribute bad things in any system, then the system would be as ideal and great as in a utopian society. Okay? Right? You know, your society is a society where there is nothing wrong. Ram Raj. How do you achieve it? Each one of us has to contribute. Alright? Doing physics and in particular quantum mechanics, we need to be able to understand this. Okay? Alright, so you multiply this, all these things out, and you would have this 20 psi.
delta A, delta A, and this in this is minus iota plus iota A plus, and D square and delta B, delta B, these are two terms that are here plus psi, and this is minus of this I t delta b delta a plus I t delta a delta b. This you can see is and this is IG common, and then so IG common is all right.
Left.
this completion relation in the brain. Okay? So we have proved this here. This is all right. Now, I think maybe I can create some space here. Because now I would like to solve this equation further. So, let me see if this is longer. I think if you allow me, I would prefer to erase this part again. Okay? I want to have this for some more time. This is not wide enough. So if you like, I can create it. Okay. All right. So now, so we are still writing five log of. This is take, we want to take it further, or if you like, you can. So these are 1 term, 2 term, and 3 term, okay? So I have these 3 terms, and if you like, okay, this AB, you want to remember, is equal to I times C, okay? So I put it everything back here. This condition of AB is I C. Here. And so this is I am going to write as my psi delta square graph delta square psi. And that is equal to psi I B into I C. Is this all right? Okay. So this is I will square it. This term is minus of psi. D equal to D C psi, this is equal to minus of D C. Is this all right? Is this all right?
Yes, sir.
And so this then gives me or implies. Let me see. This implies this is now g. This is g squared. This is g. I can multiply both things by 1 by g or g inverse. Then what do I get? G inverse into delta a g whole square. Okay. And this is plus G, and this is delta B whole square. This is, and this, if I demand, you see, this bar equal to this, so minus G. Minus GC, and this is the log of this A, and this has to be greater than or equal to 0 in order that we all these things are defined in equal to space. If all these things are defined in equal to space, the log of any state must be positive. That is what we are doing. Okay? Alright? So, very good. So, this is what's the definite and the existence. If I think line, I can also write it and get to that.
Oh, yes, this G has to go away, correct. Is that right?
Yes.
You wanted to say that? Correct. Because we are multiplying the whole thing by G inverse. Okay? Very good. Very good. And you see, when I define this operator P like that, I should have mentioned that this G is a constant parameter. Okay? This G is a constant parameter. Not constant, but a constant parameter. Okay? Alright? So, now I have this, and I can minimize this equation with respect to G. Okay? So, if I minimize it with respect to G, what do I get? Essentially, you will take its derivative with respect to G, and it will get to 0. Right? So, it's very simple. This is minus 1. Into G into the power minus, okay, times this from here it's only one power, so this is, and this gives me 0. So this